We're back. We're live. Here we go.
More explosive action coming up.
Kunlun Fight 69 live from Hainan, China.
Kevin Noon,
John Nutt, the Irish-American Connection.
接下来我们开始的是2017年巨兽之战
the action, live on Fox Sports, live on the Kunlun
app.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are set for the Kunlun Fight 2017 Super Heavyweight World Championship A Semifinal. Making his way to the ring and representing Iran, Iraj Azizpour.
And here he comes, the big, bad, bold Iranian, Iraj Azizpour. Of course, in the quarterfinals, he defeated Chinese fighter Ye Yang in a thunderous fashion. It was a war of attrition. This big boy can bang. Fighting out of Muay Thai Academy in Bangkok. 61 fights, 58 wins, 3 knockouts. He's one fight on Kunlun, one win. Here we go. Iraj.
Kevin Noon telling you what's up. I am John Nutt, and I am the co-commentator here, Kunlun Fight 69, as the big boys come out to play. Big boys come out and play. Oh, and what a big boy it is. I'm always a fan of the fighters from Iran, if you will. These guys know how to bang, and bang he does at the Muay Thai Academy, former Rambo gym, and also the home of Sesan Ghazari, the referee with the most here at Kunlun Fights. Big export shop shout out, if you will. And yeah, we've seen this guy lay his gloves on jaws and rotate them around the head. So he makes his way into the KLF ring, gives the salute, and he will be taking on China's own Asihati, who had a fantastic win over Jairo Kusunoki-san, who I very much
KO.
Enjoy. Yeah, huge KO.
Huge KO on the last Kunlun fight.
来自中国, 天山哈萨克族的勇士, 天山征服者, Asihati.
And as John mentioned, here he is. He actually looks Japanese.
Oh yeah.
But he's a Chinese-born, Chinese killer. 27 years of age, 20 fights, 5 losses, 10 KO victories, 7 wins on Kunlun. Here we go. China versus Iran, semi-final number one, the 100-plus kilogram tournament. Mongolian, I would say.
Oh, yeah. Eastern
wow.
China, Western Mongolia.
How pretty is that belt?
He spoke Mandarin, but I believe he also speaks Uzbekistan and a lot of the other Russian dialects, if you will, from those Stanish areas. I know how those Stanish areas like to be called Stanish areas, by the way, so
sure,
don't mess with me when it comes to the international global.
John, did you see the amount of
fanfare that Murat was just getting outside? Is that what you're talking about?
He had to run away in the end.
Oh, yeah.
He had to physically run away.
Yeah.
Hightail it back to the changing rooms. The amount of Chinese fight fans taking selfies with him was uninhibited. It was just crazy.
Disrespectful. It was disrespectful. Joking.
He should enjoy the moment, though. You should,
oh, he is.
You gotta savor it. You gotta. Anyways, we move on.
Introducing
to the
first, the man
the
fighting
boys.
Out of the blue corner. He stands blue 188
corner.
Centimeters, his age 29. His professional record outstanding at 58 victories, opposite 3 losses. A Muay Thai world champion. Fighting out of Iran, Iraj Azizpour.
The big man. Iranian.
Oh, yeah.
Bangkok trained, Bangkok ready.
Oh yeah.
来自天山的哈萨克族勇士, 身高1米88, 职业战绩20胜5负10次 KO 对手，他是中国的全国拳击锦标赛的冠军, 拥有扎实的拳击功底, 是拳击手转型打自由搏击最顶尖的大级别选手。 让我们欢迎红方选手, 来自哈萨克族的天山征服者阿萨提。 有请场上裁判毛景宇。
Your referee, Mao Jingyu.
Here we go.
Okay, this is a Kunlun fight, kickboxing, 3 rounds, 3 minutes. No hip, no elbow, no clinch. Okay?
27-year-old Asihati.观众
朋友大家好，您正在收看的是昆仑决首届搏击春晚，我是昆仑决亚伟。
And again, one of these guys looking to strap up that big belt around their waist by the end of the evening. Iraj, an absolute monster, with another Godzilla-like creature in front of him. These are, it's basically like K1 versus Everest. I mean, it's two mountains, the Himalayas.Versus the Rockies right now. As Iraj pumping out the jab, looking to range. And the first strikes are about to be.
You're definitely going to see a bit of a tense interpretation here. Both fighters, they know they possess big power in those fists.
Anytime you're over 100 kgs, I don't care who you are.
Exactly.
The game is obviously going to be slower because we move slower as large men.
There you go.
But I can tell you what, when the 2x4 strikes, it breaks. Hacksaw Jim Duggan in the house.
Oh!
And there it is. Plants him on his butt. First round, overhand right. See if he can do it again. It doesn't stall his opponent. He's back to his feet. And he's...
Both guys have had their chins. I've seen both guys fight on a couple of occasions. And I've seen both guys take huge, powerful punches. Like John mentioned, big guys have power. Slower, but by power. And they both have good granite chins. Let's see how well they're tested tonight.
Yeah, well, I like how Iraj shook his head at that. Shaking your head when you're a big boy means one of two things. No, I did not feel it, or yes, I feel it, and I want you to not feel like I felt it. So
I would go with the latter on that one.
Smiling.
Or maybe the former, who knows?
But again, these low kicks, these, you know, a lot of people think that when you have tree trunks for legs, you can take them all day.
No.
Man, you can't take them all day. You won't be dancing. And big men want to dance, you know? It's what we're about.
Iraj just looks like he's setting that right hand up to strike with thunder right now. It's the way he's positioned.
Oh, yeah, it's cock locked and loaded. It is.
Whereas Asihati just looks like he's content with letting the jab go.
What's funny for me is I actually think they're respecting each other too much. Spinning stuff, trying to get the kids on his side. Because we all know the kids love the spinning stuff.
Yeah, there could be a bit too much respect going on right now. Excellent point there. Ooh, caught a flush on the jaw, right? Nice big shot.
And that's what I want to see. I want to see the slugfest.
Yes, that's what we all want to see. You know we're going to see that in the next fight.
Well, of course.
With the Brazilian kid and the Ukrainian boy, that's just going to be a complete war. Because not only are they big men, they're fit.
Of course.
Movement. No disrespect to these two fighters, but it'll be a different contextual situation in that bout.
And again, fitness is not judged by body type, but what you're discussing is the way that the other two men look is Greek godlike,
yes.
And not as doughy, if you will, as right now.
You'll see what I'm talking about in about 15 minutes' time.
End of round one. Heavyweight action happening here. Kunlun Fight 69, Guiyang. It's all going down.
It's cold outside the ring,
freezing.
But it's hot in the squared circle right now.
Oh, that it is. Asihati not even wanting to sit down.
He's not even going to take a water break?
Nope, I don't need to. What I need to do is I need to pick up my pace,
yes,
and I need to perform my game, which we've seen before involves a lot of overhand rights to the chin. I again would like to see more of that. Both these guys, I feel like, respected each other a little too much in that first round, and we want to see a little lumber laid here in round number deuce.
I'm looking for the Iranian fighter Iraj to unload that big right hand a lot more in the second round. And Asihati needs to get busier with everything.
Round two,
I think John definitely hit the nail on the head there. There was too much respect shown in that opening round, the opening stanza. Here we go, round number two. Iraj Azizpour from Iran taking on Asihati, Chinese man.
And they switch it up. Now, what's interesting about this is Big Iraj took center stage and he immediately tries for ring control. Lateral movement came from Asihati along with the big right. And it slowed down the ring control of the Iranian fighter Iraj. You can already see it. Even though the punch might not have like landed for a KO, it has changed the game of Iraj.
Something big is coming right now.
Asihati is on the... I actually think he went down on purpose right there. He's shaking his head, but I think that was a stall tactic.
Yeah, break the momentum.
Yep.
It's a technique many a fighter will use, right?
Oh, and a big guy has to do it every now and again. You know, I don't think of it as even as taking a fall or taking a trip. I literally do think of it as a breaking the concentration of somebody that's in their game. So you want to stop the flow of that viscosity again that's going on Asahadi's side. He takes a little bit of a dip. But you can really tell that straight jab. He might be shaking his head, saying that it's not doing anything. It's definitely working. Asahadi's on pace.
He's on the ascendancy right now, no question about that.
Again, another stiff jab.
And as we talked about earlier, every punch is important for these big boys. No question about that. Because they're not going to throw 20,000 punches like a middleweight or a welterweight.
No. And again, these ones that are scoring,
he's disoriented
the
right
now. Oh, good for him to land the kick. Good for him to land the kick, but
came out of nowhere. Wow.
Asahati
is fighting the smartest fight right now, in the eyes of you and I.
Oh, he's in control.
And I really believe that all those jabs that are landing on the nose of Iraj, they're affecting his breathing.
Oh, for sure.
You can
for
see sure. that. He's definitely slowing down in every aspect.
In the Thai language, hai jai mai ong. The wind is not coming out the right way. So his lungs aren't able to, once again.
You've taken a few yoga classes in Bangkok?
Of course, bro, of course.
Second round, final 27 seconds. Asihati from China seems to be in control of the fight right now.
At least he's finding a home for the venom gloves.
Yes.
And that home is the face of Iraj.
Iraj needs to, that's what he needs to do. Come back with combinations. Final 10 seconds, round number two.
Oh, he came back with another head kick. It didn't quite land on its target, but... Oh, that one landed.
He's got a counter. He's got a counter. That's huge, John.
Huge. He's not going to be able to get up.
Get him over.
Wow.
And the crit call for the referee. Crit call for the referee. No, not at all.
Iraj, we thought he was on pace to be losing this fight. Comes in with a huge kick. Not last minute, last second. He is overwhelmed with joy. You can see the tears almost welding up in his eyes. He really is overly happy. But that man right there, Asihati, he was doing a great job. He was bringing his game plan to the fight. And again, not last minute, last second, receives a big kick to the neck.
John, it would be very disingenuous of you and I to say that was a lucky kick.
Oh, yeah.
Because
I don't think it was lucky. He did it twice during the fight already.
There you go. Exactly.
Here it is, though.
That's a wild moment.
Boom.
Chin
you can see.
On chin.
Yep.
Perfect.
Right on the earlobe.
Whoa. He was done.
It's so funny. If he could have lasted, if it was 2 seconds later.
Fatigue. Does that play a part in that?
Oh, yeah.
In that stoppage? I think it does, right? I can feel my voice going now. It's so cold here in China right now. It's definitely affecting our vocal cords. So the big Iranian, no pun intended, moves on
to
the final, where he will face off against one of two Greek gods.
This is a very dramatic fight. 阿斯哈提在第二回合占尽了优势，几乎要获得胜利的时候，在最后一刻居然发生了逆转。本场比赛经过裁判的裁定，蓝方选手在第二回合三分整 KO 获胜。
Your winner by knockout, the blue corner.
What a great win for Iraj. The big Iranian is in the finals, looking for that belt to be wrapped around his waist this evening. I do find it funny, again, I think that he was stalled, I think that he was down, I think he was out. If I think if it had maybe gone a third round, it would be a different story. But again, you can't take that kick away because he had already landed it once and he had tried it twice. So maybe that was part of his game plan, and kudos to the Iranian.